Speak to that man in the blue shirt, Ryan Ciampoli, who tells me that before he's a firefighter, he is a father. So the moment that he pulled up to that scene there was a very heartbreaking scene. That paternal instinct immediately kicked in, rushing to that four-year-old little girl, as you see there, carefully picking her up off that asphalt and then eventually taking her onto the bed of a pickup truck to wait for even more help to arrive. Mr. Ciampoli also speaking to our colleague, Frederico Whitfield, in the last couple of hours. I want you to hear directly from him how he describes what was a truly heartbreaking scene.
It was just unbelievable. You know, one minute I'm just driving down the road, and the next minute I see a little girl swing open the door on this church bus and fall to the highway. It was heartbreaking, but instantly, you know, I used my EMS training and firefighter training and assessed the scene as best as I could. I realized that it wasn't a good place for her laying there. You know, typically, you know, in EMS, we're not supposed to move the patient unless they're in a pretty dangerous situation. And because she was on a state highway there in Harrison, Arkansas, it was grounds to get her out of there. I couldn't stand for her to get hit by a car or someone hit us both.
As Ciampoli also told me that he has responded to many calls for help during his career as an EMT, volunteer firefighter and an EMT, but it is always those involving children that are the ones that are very difficult to forget. This is obviously one that fortunately has a good ending on it. To answer your second question, that little girl is doing okay. She, mom apparently saying that she did break her jaw and will have to undergo some surgeries, but is expected to eventually make a full recovery. But again, if it weren't for this man, we can only imagine what the outcome could have been.
What about that bus door? How did she manage to open it?
That's a key question here, and that's something that we've been trying to answer all day, trying to find out maybe who was the operator of that bus. We know that Mr. Ciampoli told us that it was a church bus, but we have not been able to find the facility or the place that actually kept that bus. So that is a key question, to find out whether or not that bus was possibly fitted with some kind of special devices, or whether or if it wasn't, to be able to prevent that door from swinging open. But Mr. Ciampoli did tell me that that bus driver did eventually come back to this scene several minutes later. But now the question is, how was this four-year-old little girl able to open that door, as you see it there, swing open? And then eventually, well, that little girl sustained some very serious injuries, some that she'll be able to recover from.
Oh, thankfully that she's okay. There's a happy ending to that story. Paula Sandoval, thank you.